So my name is Ramesh Nivoria from Nishant Bioenergy India. This is my third year into European Environment Foundation Convention, and we are manufacturing biomass fuel pellet plants and biomass fuel pellet stores. And we are creating green enterprise business model where these technologies are used to create a livelihood and also carbon neutral fuel. This way we are creating replication things at many places, and right now with the coming to this in European Environment Foundation, we found partners, and last year we found partner in Nepal. This year we are going to Madagascar, and also talks are going on with Bangladesh and other one more country. So it's good for me to come here and share my business model with them, and also get knowledge from other partners here. Okay, thank you.
Hello, good morning. So I'm Ramesh from Nishant Bioenergy Private Limited, a company in India making biomass fuel pellet plants and pellets too, especially for commercial kitchens, big kitchens. And we are creating this through a green enterprise business model, where we are giving the technology to the enterprise who employs the local people and install the store in their network. And this way, this creates a local sustainable energy solutions, creating employment and livelihood. So what happened in the big kitchens, cost of increasing the LPG is getting high in the fuel prices, food prices. In India, like big kitchens, like these are the religious places, and other places like restaurant, college canteens, company canteens, they use LPG for cooking. So with the increase in LPG prices, the cost of cooking is going up. And most of the developing countries are importing the LPG and fossil fuels, and with the increase in the international oil prices and the dollar prices, these local LPG prices and fuel prices are increasing. On the other side, this is unemployment at the village level is also increasing. And this is unstable, so this is going to rise every year. So what is our solution? We have a solution which is a cook stove which is running on biomass fuel pellets. And this 1 kg of LPG can be replaced with 2.5 kg of pellets. And you can see the pricing. We can save half of the cost of LPG cooking. So we also supply this pellet plants. So this make a combination. So for creating employees. Every 10 stone use create one sustainable job. That job is creating pellets from agro waste and also supplying the pellets to the local consumers. So we are into this line since last 15 years. We installed our first stove in 1999. Now we are manufacturing the pellet stove at this pellet field small plants. We have designs for different cooking things. Already installed more than 2,500 stores, and we have sold 4 big plants, and 2 more plants are coming up, and these 2 more small plants are coming up. We are cash positive company, so we have no grant and all any money, donor money. So this is purely commercial business. We are already running a carbon credit project for our stores. We have signed ELPA, which is for $3.5 million with a Swiss buyer. And we also won this Aston Award and other in India. So what we do, we, Nishant Bioenergy, sells the the pellet plants to green enterprises. These green enterprises are local, small businesses. So they get the pellet plants and also get the stoves. So now they get the training, business know-how from us, and they are independent to run their business. And they are these green enterprises getting the biomass from farmers, agro industries to convert them into the pellets, and they sell the pellet to the consumers, and then they sell the stove. So this makes a local solution, and he employs the local people to make the pellets. And also we get the carbon credit for this project. and we share the carbon credit of this enterprise with them. 75% of carbon credit goes to this enterprise. So it is making more commercially viable. So what is green enterprise? Green enterprise, as I told you, this is small businesses, which is having 100 stove project with him. And he employs around 6 to 7 people and make around 2 to 3 tons of pallet per day to supply these local stove users. So he gets all the training for the technical training from us for the plants and how to maintain the stoves, how to run the stoves, and also how to keep the logging of the detail of the stoves, where it's installed, all things we get into the database and to collect the carbon credits. So the capital investment for this 100 stove project is approximately $41,000. And it can be, this payback period is less than 2 years. So this is complete advantage, and what he puts up this green enterprise business model. So he has advantages. There are other extra things which can come into his business as a competition, like LPG stove, electric stove, solar cookers, and the pallets, other people who are entering the pallet market. So it is other advantage because he's having our own pallet plant and own network. So he can easily take on this competition. So we have a small people of team. And we have a manufacturing workshop here at our place in Chandigarh, where we have 12 people working for this. So this is social and environmental benefit of the one enterprise. So take up this meeting, sorry, this is the one figure. So every green enterprise having 100 stoves can achieve the savings to the users $290,000. This is a saving can be achieved by the people who are using the stove per year. And he's paying approximately $38,000 to the local biomass suppliers, like farmers, agro waste, or sawdust. And he's employing the 90 directly and indirectly. Indirectly, people who are supplying the pallet to the end consumers. And he himself can earn approximately 45,000 at 100% capacity. So with this business, he can save 1,000 tons of CO2. So he is economical, he's creating employment, he's creating livelihood, and also saving the environment. So this is a small plant, which make pellets, so it's very easy to break. And this is the stove, you can see that. Thank you.